watch it together at TV.
So I get a lot of people coming up to me in petrol stations. Most people don't know what it is. It turns heads before you even come around the corner. People are already looking for whatever it is. Yeah, they don't. They don't quite understand how we've done it. Forums and stuff for these, it's people that want to go camping. So it's all kind of guys with little tweed jackets and the Jack Russells, and all they want to do is make tea and sit about and have a natter. Most of the guys that own these are like in their 50s and they don't want to go fast. I drove it for about a year and a half, pretty standard. Put some wheels on it, lowered it, but nothing else really. Maybe a couple of colour changes. I think I colour-coded the bumpers at that point. I blew the engine up coming back from London one day, doing about 80 on the A303, which a vehicle like this shouldn't really do that speed. So I basically boiled all the fluid and left 16 litres of coolant all over the A303. I met up with one of the guys from the VDUB forum, guy called Lance, who had a Volkswagen van as well, and he was thinking about doing a Subaru conversion. He had this car sat around that he wasn't doing anything with, so I got a whole Subaru for 450 quid. He wasn't sure whether the engine was good, so I took it back to my place, fixed a couple of little bits, took it out straight away, did more than the legal speed limit up the road, came back, started stripping the car down. One of the things I wanted to get right on the truck was the sort of stance and the way it sits on the floor and how it looks. And the wheels make a massive difference to that. It took me probably 6 months to get the right wheels that I was happy with. It's got 10-inch banded steels at the back. They're 16-inch rims from the Mercedes truck. And then the fronts are the spares off the Mercedes CLK. They're 17-inch by 7 wide. It was quite nice that the offset was perfect for the vehicle, so they sit really nicely in the arches. Lowered it a bit more just to get it to sit on the floor nicely. I bought it just as a means of moving bikes around. It's pretty standard when I got it. Didn't have any mods on it. It was really pretty knackered with a lot of rust in it. I've known Bobby for about 20 years. We met up through mountain biking. Bobby was a graphic designer at the time, and then he decided he wanted to start Zealous, tuning Skylines primarily, although he loves all sorts of cars. He's had Volkswagens, but his main passion is Jap cars. His Skyline is absolutely amazing. He's spent so many hours on it. I've helped him take the engine in and out at least 3 times. All he wants to do is get oily and play with Skylines, so. I'd already started stripping the truck down and taking a lot of parts off of it for the rebuild, and I was just gonna literally fling the engine in there to get me going. But Bob persuaded me to, if we're gonna do it, we might as well do it properly. So we ended up pretty much replacing every single panel from about the waistline on the truck down. I really can't fathom to wonder how much money I've actually spent on it. I think it probably owes me somewhere in the region of 5,000 to 6,000, I'd have thought. I'd quite like to do a twin turbo conversion on it and sit the turbos right at the back, but I think that would mean a lot more power in the vehicle, and at the moment it's pretty much at its limit anyway. I think any more power and it's going to spin its wheels more, which is not ideal. it's quite well suited as it is, so. And people are always pretty shocked when they see it. Like a lot of the toll gates in France and stuff is pretty cool, because you always get that little drag race off the toll gates and the gate lifts up and there's a little sports car next to you and you absolutely annihilate him and they look at you, they come up like that and they go. So you always get a nice wave. Some people get upset, but on the most part, people are happy to see it. So some guys get it, some guys just clearly don't know what I'm doing. I kind of flip between the Skyline guys and the Subaru guys and the V-Dub guys. But now recently I found a bunch of guys in Bath, they're Volkswagen Retro and Dub Club. And they're more into like modifying stuff for the hell of it and having fun really. So I think I'll get more heavily involved with those guys.
Live it only on Tegevia TV.